This is Will Nunziata, New York City-based director and creator of theater, television, and film. Once again, I am joined on translation by the incredible Qiren Chen. And today, ladies and gentlemen, we have Singapore's Nanyin composer. And boy, is he acclaimed and award-winning, the one and only Wu Qiren. Mr. Wu Qiren, I would just want to start from the beginning and actually go to the expertise that you are so acclaimed for, Nanyin. Can you explain to the audience what exactly Nanyin is and how you began your association with this beautiful, beautiful music?
Wu Qiren老师今天他非常荣幸能采访到您，他知道您是我们新加坡还有华人界的一位著名的男音作曲家，所以他的第一个问题是想 让您给我们介绍一下南音这种艺术表达形式，然后他想问您是什么时候发现自己与南音有着不解之缘，能跟我们分享一下吗？介绍一下南音是吗？我简短的讲，南音是源于中国的汉朝2000多年前跟1000多年前的唐朝的宫廷音乐。
那因为战乱，里面的乐师就逃到福建南方，然后就在泉州传开了，就是唐朝跟汉朝距离现在1800年至2000年左右，就逐步传到中国福建的南方，福建在泉州就 变成现在南音了，它的原始的东西是在宫廷皇帝在听的那个音乐传下来，所以南音的历史是有1000多年的历史，是这样。好，然后另外能不能跟我们分享一下您与南音是怎样的一个过往，是什么时候 发现自己对南音有？南音是一种曲牌，你如果知道，就我们中国的诗人写诗啊，写词，它有一个固定的叫词牌，多少字，什么押韵都有规定的。什么相思引啦，一交啦，降水，这个每一个曲牌不一样，它的音调都不一样，调式也不一样。比如说我举一个例子，叫相思引的一个曲牌，一音上，歌声一波，更难心意呀。这如果用西洋音乐来解释，它只是一句上句，还有一个下句，它南音就是两句，勾成一个乐段，南音是这样的，跟中国民间的那个什么起承转合完全不一样，因为它这个是来自于古老的 皇宫里面都是知识分子比较多的音乐，所以流传到现在，它这个音乐算是非常古老的，有非常丰富的一些资料。So
Will, he gave a short introduction to what Nanyin is. It is a form of music that was listened to by the royal emperor back in the Han and Tang dynasty about 1,000 to 2,000 years ago. So those players of Nanyin music are often court scholars, people with a lot of literature background. So Nanyin is a form of combining music and poems and lyrics. And so he said that back then, those refugee musicians, they're trying to escape from a war. And so they ran to Fujian province in the southern part of China from the north. And soon they had a settlement in Quanzhou, and they popularized this form of music locally.
It's incredible. I love it. And what I also love so much about what you are doing, Mr. Wu, is that you are cultivating a new generation of Nanyin musicians and fusing their craft with the Chinese traditional music with modern pop elements. Why is it so important for you that the future musicians in China and beyond get to know and spread this very important music?
Thank you, Will. 吴老师他接下来一个问题呢是想知道因为他知道您在做南音艺术家你也在培植我们很有才艺的人士所以他知道您在教育过程中会把南音我们很传统的中国的古典的音乐与我们流行元素结合起来所以他对此非常的好奇然后想问您能不能跟我们分享一下与就是我们培植新人这方面的重要性
这次我给福建的厦门乐团南音乐团写了一个文姬归汉是汉朝的东汉的一个人物他的老爸是一个大学者那他也是一个女才子那这次的给南音的他的唱腔我就用很传统的那个南音来写但是他其他的一些常表现他的情绪了什么我就吸收了我们现代的东西创作的作曲的手法也是用现代的东西传统的原料现代的手法去把它写出来我发出了那个视频里面有一段什么蒙古的就是匈奴啊东汉匈奴 侵略中国蔡文姬被抓去内蒙古做刽子然后他就在那边唱歌的时候我就引用了现在的蒙古的音调还有蔡文姬的那个胡笳十八坡都是从唐朝就流传到现在现在就是这个文姬归汉就是有2000年流传下来的音乐 也有现代几百年前的音乐那但是它的作曲的手法就不是纯粹南音的很古老的办法用我们新的我是毕业于上海音乐学院就吸取了新的创作手法用原来的材料把它写出来这个文姬归汉这个现在正在第二次版正在排 那个文姬归汉就这次国家给的基金奖励三个国家福建省还有厦门市都给他很多支持这个戏今年六月会公开演出所以这次是这个就是比以前的其他的纯南音要来的既是古代的 就是两千年的东西又有现代的东西是现代的东西是我们新的写创作手法把它结合起来因为我是上海音乐学院毕业的我就可以运用这样现在在厦门排练各方面的人都感到非常感兴趣
Well, so when so Mr. Wu, he's working on this project about a female scholar Cai Wenji, and back in the Northern Han Dynasty, and it's a folk and also a historical figure. Back then, we were being invaded by the Mongolians. So it's about this lady being captured and she's trying to return to her home country. He, according to Wu himself, he graduated from the Shanghai Academy of Music. So he likes to combine the traditional elements, but remaking it with the modern technique. So he said that this project has won 3 national grants. And in June this year, it's going to make the public debut in Xiamen. So he's really proud of that.
That's incredible. Well, listen, Mr. Wu, I'm so excited you're coming on board FENIX 360 as one of its global artist ambassadors, because not only in the East are you cultivating and inspiring young students and musicians to combine these traditional techniques with modern techniques, but you're showing the world and also here in the West the possibilities of looking back to look forward. And how important that is for our young musicians all over the world. And I think it's your mindset, Mr. Wu, that is needed now more than ever. A celebration of the tradition of one's past to move forward in the future and celebrating what was before, the foundational elements of specifically this beautiful, beautiful music, Nanyin. Well, listen, Mr. Wu, I could speak with you forever. I want to let Chu Chen know, thank you once again for your incredible translation. And Mr. Wu, you are once again a perfect example of an artist that not only is award-winning and acclaimed and doing such amazing things yourself, but for legacy, you are inspiring the future Mr. Wu's of the world with kindness, with your talent, and with your beautiful spirit. And I am so grateful for your time today.